Tonight's special segment, the business is turning to bloggers to get their message out. It's all part of efforts to find new ways to reach consumers. ABC 7 Cheryl Burton joining us with more on the story tonight. Cheryl?
Well, Kathy and Ron, many companies use the power of the internet to pitch new products, but some are now offering popular bloggers freebies or flights across the country to check out new product lines. And that has left some critics wondering if these companies are just creating buzz or buying the blogs.
I'm extremely impressed.
At the headquarters for the Sears Holdings Corporation in Hoffman Estates, bloggers are buzzing.
Last night we had like a cocktail party where we had dinner. We got to mingle and meet all the other moms.
Sears flew in 16 bloggers from across the country to get an exclusive look at their fall lines for Sears and Kmart. The event was so exclusive that Sears kept our cameras out until the summit was over.
I think it's good business.
Janelle Laban says her blog posted on ApartmentTherapy.com reaches 150,000 readers a day.
I think it makes sense for people who want to speak to that audience to work with us.
It should almost be a paid advertisement.
David Kohler teaches marketing at the University of Illinois at Chicago. He says by giving bloggers free products and trips, companies are buying positive reviews.
It's definitely going to taint the credibility of the blog because you know that that person received benefits. And if you're receiving benefits, such as what Sears had provided, you are very likely to look at the positives.
What we really wanted to accomplish was more listening than pushing something on someone.
Rob Harles runs new media efforts for Sears. He says the company is turning to bloggers to get unfiltered opinions.
They have a lot of insight that you can get from them very, very quickly. And if you hit the right chord with them, they can also influence their own audiences on your behalf.
Throughout what Sears calls the Home Design Summit, the bloggers posted pictures of new products and updated their Twitter feeds, writing, "Wow, it's like heaven," and "My jaw is dropping."
Sears isn't the only company reaching out to bloggers. In fact, marketing experts say directly contacting bloggers for product reviews is the latest trend in digital marketing.
It's like a business relationship.
Tanya Gordon attended the summit. On her blog, mommygoggles.com, she reviews all kinds of products, like this brand new stainless steel refrigerator Frigidaire is sending her for free.
Technically, I mean, it is a job. It's not just send us something we're going to review and post about it. You know, we want to post our positive thoughts and negative thoughts as well.
People are trusting your personal opinion and insight.
Digital marketer Janice Bond says it's important for both bloggers and companies to make sure product reviews on blogs are unbiased.
With all of this great information and these portals to receive this information comes an even greater responsibility.
Now, later on this week, more than 1,000 bloggers will come to Chicago for BlogHer 2009, a conference designed for female bloggers. Several of the sessions will focus on the business of blogging. Kathy and Ron, one of the topics, of course, that will be discussed, blogging for money, does it actually influence your opinions? And I can tell you tonight, it's a hot debate on the Facebook page.
All right. Thanks, Cheryl.
Thanks.
The city of Chicago is trying to figure out why to live.